Hello, I'm a Sanitarian lecturer in metallurgy, and I preach Christianity, Sikhism, and real Islam, which is Sharia free. And this is the age of Holy Spirit, and not of the dead letters. Holy Spirit is common sense. So if you have common sense, then you will have covenant with Christ Jesus. If you have dead in letters, then you have covenant with Satan. Letter killeth, spirit giveth life. So it is, you need to be a person of spirit to have life and live peacefully. While men of dead letters, they just are making the world a hell, as you can see it now. So I have written something and go through. Hi, the sons of man, faithful to their tribal fathers, and the creator, demiurge, Potter Yahweh, gets their laws written over their hearts. Voice of the sons of Satan, laws are written in the law books, in ink on paper. So the author of this one body is called Yahweh Brahma Khuda. So these laws are natural laws, because this is nature, natural law, tit for tat, as Moses was, you know. So in spirit, you know, we have love called Agape, in which we have no enemy or stranger. So we don't kill each other or anything like that. So the creator of this flesh is jealous and repentful. Our living father of our soul is loving and merciful. Just the opposite. So, go to the Brazilian or the African jungles and see how the people live peacefully in harmony with nature. And there are no tornadoes, fires, earthquake, or other natural disasters. They are looked after by Yahweh, for they are faithful to Him, and He looks after them. So they are faithful to Yahweh, because it is the Yahweh who created Adam and Eve and all that, you know. All that you see with the two naked eyes is creation of Yahweh. The soul inside is, which makes them living, is of Elohim. And the Christ is the son of Elohim. So Jesus came from Elohim. They are looked after by Yahweh, for they are faithful to Him, and He looks after them. He looks after that they are well fed and they are not hungry and all that. And you will see over there, the nature has tree and everything. Where people are unfaithful, over there, you know, they have, there is not that feeding. Natural resources are very limited. So if Yahweh is the reporter, he is demiurge, the greater than Yahweh is the Elohim, which make it living. Father of our souls, which is called Allah, Parbrahm in our language. How much our real supernatural Father, He is the real one, because without soul you are dead. Real supernatural Father of our souls, Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm, would be looking after you in the gospel truth if we become His faithful sons in the Holy Spirit, as the Samaritan man who picked up the wounded person and looked after him philanthropically. I will sort it later on. And looked after him philanthropically. He did not ask for money, you know, because in the royal kingdom of God, when you enter, you don't take any money in your pocket. No two shoe, no two tunic, and no script. Script means Bible is forbidden. And that's why St. Paul said in 2 Corinthians 3, I'm not flashing degrees. I got degrees from, in dead letters from Jerusalem University. As these people are in Oxford, Cambridge universities, they have dead letters. They flash their degree. I'm PhD, I'm doctor of theology, this and that. But they are none in Holy Spirit. They have nothing. They have zero Holy Spirit. What is written, they go by it. What is not written, they don't want to know it. Because that is by the grace of our supernatural Father. For example, the names of the five husbands of the Samaritan woman are well known in India. And I have put it in there, in description, their names, which are at the bottom of the description. Trinity. But these university professors, when I tell them that these are the names of that Samaritan woman, because I tell them in spirit and not in the dead letters, so they don't want to know me. So that means the gospel, which is Holy Spirit, you learn through Holy Spirit, they are not interested, but only in the dead letters, which you learn as the once born people do. So he looked after them philanthropic wise. Two men of dead letters, Pharisee and Sadducee or Rabbi, passed by. That he is not one of ours in Eros. Eros is the love that he created among the once born people when they are faithful to their tribal father. If they are not faithful to their tribal father, there is no Eros, but hatred. Thus the men of God, like the Salvation Army people, look after the strangers in Agape. If you see, you know, Salvation Army people are the best. They will look after you. And when their soldier died, When the soldier died in the World War I and World War II, they say they died for king and country. Whereas Church of England soldiers, when they die, their priest tells them that they glorify God. What type of God was glorified looting and killing people? So that is of Satan. The sons of Satan controlling Mammon and Media. You know, there are two things. You are poor, no Mammon, like Lazarus sitting at the door of the rich man. His wounds were licked by dogs. He did not bother the rich man. But when both died, the rich man went into the hell, and Lazarus sitting in the lap of Abraham. So these people in Mammon, rich people in America, it is they who are creating havoc in the world, killing people in one country after the other. And here is a cartoon produced by a deputy head of the Green Party. And it was published by the Jewish newspaper, but as soon as they came to know that, oh, it's against them, they took it off. I made a copy of it. So it's a good idea to have a banner made out of this one to display that who is the culprit in destroying the one country after the other. The sons of Satan, they are of none. Satan means destruction. So they only know destruction, not construction. Sons of man, they construct. Sons of Satan, they destroy. So let's carry on. I put a lot of things on the other videos, which if you're interested, you will find it. Thus, the men of God, like the Salvation Army, look after the strangers in agape, unconditional divine love. Whilst the dead in letters, limited to their own in arrows, but they don't know anybody. They don't want to know him at all. So they are racist, you know, in the human nature. The sons of Satan controlling Mammon and Media in America and in European countries, mostly they are Jewish people, have bombarded the innocent people of Yahweh, and Yahweh is not sitting idle. Yahweh is going to teach them a good lesson in the economic chaos and suffering through viruses and natural disasters like tornadoes and typhoons, earthquakes and other things. Because Christ Jesus, the very anointed Son of Elohim, in which we exercise agape, is greater than the natural potter, Yahweh, demiurge, which is Eros. So this blasphemy of Blair and Bush, that Saddam Hussain had weapons of mass destruction, would create a great havoc among the sons of Satan, which are the rich in Mammon. Why, the poor will not suffer. Poor in Africa and Brazilian jungle. In Brazilian jungle, in some part of jungle, they don't want to know money. They don't put money in their pocket. There's no transactions in money. So Mammon is out. As when the first Church of God was formed, people sold all their possessions and gave it to the people, poor people, and entered the fold without any money in their pocket. Whereas Onions and Sapira, they sold their possessions, but they kept back money. And they told Peter, that's all they got out of the sale. He asked them twice. And third time he said, you're not coming into this church. You're coming of your own free will. We are not forcing you. And then why tell blasphemy against Holy Spirit? So they were both killed. So that is the standard of the sheep which Peter has set up. And he used to give the first sermon was by Peter, laying the foundation in truth, what you see with two naked eyes. Then the apostle will give them a lecture, telling them about blasphemy against Holy Spirit or cleaning their heart. First one was this, against sin. Sin and blasphemy come from your heart. I hope it makes clear. Our Father God bless you in Holy Spirit. In Holy Spirit, which is common sense, and agape, unconditional divine love.